Ulbrich stainless steels and special metals, celebrating 75 years on the cutting edge. The 20s was a time of prosperity and confidence for America. Jobs were plentiful, the soldiers home from the war needed housing. Times were good for hard-working men and women. Frederick Christian Ulbrich, a young 23-year-old scrap metal inspector for the United States Steel Company in Donora, Pennsylvania, returned to his hometown in Wallingford, Connecticut to start a scrap metal and used auto parts business in the spring of 1924. Fred bought old rusted farm equipment and also bought demolished roadsters. Back at his yard, he dismantled them. He sold scrap to the steel mills and other usable parts to the motoring public. Fred worked hard. Soon his reputation for reliable scrap and good used auto parts grew. When it first began to regulate scrap yards, the state of Connecticut awarded Fred its very first permit.
The development of stainless steel would have a lasting impact on Fred's scrap business. Germany was the first to use stainless steel for armament during World War I. Stainless, now referred to as alloy 301, was then called Krupp austenitic No. 2, after the large Krupp munitions and steel complex. In the late 1920s, Krupp licensed the Ludlum Corporation in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania to melt the alloy. They sent the metal to the Wallingford Steel Company in Connecticut to roll it into flat coils. Fred was selling scrap metal to about a half dozen melting mills, including Ludlum Corporation. At night, he studied metallurgy at Yale University and became a pioneer in the stainless steel industry in this country. With the metal being resistant to rust, Fred knew the tremendous potential it would have for manufacturing automotive, household, architectural hardware, and cutlery products.
The 1929 stock market crash started the Great Depression that left many people jobless and without hope. During the 1930s, many hobos were riding the rails. In Wallingford, the hobo stop was Fred's scrapyard. His wife, Ada, would feed the men. In return, they helped Fred build a 60-foot addition to his building. In 1936, the Ludlum Company merged with Allegheny Steel, and Fred lost the scrap account. With business slow, it was time for a new enterprise. The Wallingford, Meriden, Connecticut area was the second largest cutlery manufacturing center in the world. One of Fred's major scrap accounts, the Stay-Brite Corporation, made stainless steel cutlery. Since Fred knew the cutlery industry and the properties of stainless steel, he decided to manufacture a diner quality cutlery line of knives, forks, and spoons. Diners were very popular all over the country. The utensils were simple in design, relatively easy to make, and very inexpensive.
The Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor drew America into World War II. Fred Ulbrich's small but profitable cutlery business was awarded the Army Mess Kit Knife Contract, a quality, all-purpose knife that GIs would use in all types of weather all over the world. Fred could not acquire the stainless steel in the thickness or width he needed to fulfill the government orders quickly. He purchased a used rolling mill and slitter and retooled them. He could now roll and slit his own metal to the specifications required for the Army knives. Ulbrich fulfilled orders faster and more accurately than its competitors and received additional orders for knives. Business boomed. The Army contract was the birth of Ulbrich becoming a specialty re-roll mill as we know it today. After the war, Fred formed the Victory Cutlery Company that produced two lines of cutlery. One line was an expensive Elkhorn Stag handle carving set sold through leading New York City department stores. The second was the continued production of the Diner Cutlery Set, which became a joint venture with the Wallace Silversmith Company.
The post-war boom period brought growth throughout the United States. Manufactories retooled to meet the growing demand for consumer goods. Factories were unable to obtain stainless steel strip in quantities less than 10,000 pounds, and less than 2,000 pounds was next to impossible. With Ulbrich now capable of re-rolling strip, Fred seized the opportunity to sell many of his former industrial scrap accounts small quantities of stainless steel. He purchased stainless steel strip in various gauges from several mills in 10,000 pound orders and sold small quantities down to 10 pounds. Business was robust. Sales grew from $192,000 in 1952 to over $425,000 in 1953.
Orders were piling up. Fred had to ask his sister May Warzoka to run the office on a temporary basis. As the business grew, May wore many hats: office manager, traffic manager, inventory control manager, and finally vice president of purchasing. May's temporary office position would last 30 years. By the mid-1950s, Fred had sold the Victory Cutlery Company to concentrate on producing stainless steel. He purchased one of the first Zenzimer mills to be used in the industry.
The Z mill really made stainless steel. Before the advent of the Z mill, it was very difficult to hold tolerances in shape. But the Z mill was tremendous pressure, made it practical to roll stainless and at the same time retain its shape.
The Zenzimer mill, with its elaborate set of rolls which form the shape of two opposing pyramids, exert tremendous pressure on the two work rolls that touch the metal. The result is rolling the metal down to 5/10,000 of an inch within tolerances in the millionths of an inch. Such precision was unheard of in the industry. To satisfy the demand that the Z mill would create, Ulbrich invested heavily in modern annealing furnaces and additional two high mills. This capital investment launched Ulbrich from a supplier of stainless strip to one of custom re-roll precision strip. The investment paid off. Sales skyrocketed from just under $400,000 in 1954 to $1.3 million in 1956. Ulbrich now had 8 full-time and 30 part-time employees.
Fred Ulbrich Jr. entered the company on a full-time basis. He had operated various machines in the plant. He started the credit and advertising departments. By 1960, Fred Jr. had organized and directed Ulbrich's first full-time national sales force. Ulbrich now stocked special alloys for the growing aerospace industry, especially nickel alloys such as Inconel and Monel. Also, high temperature alloys such as A286, Wasp Alloy, Hastelloy X and C were in great demand.
Ulbrich now supplied metal to Pratt & Whitney, Boeing and Roar Aircraft, and their numerous subcontractors that were involved in the early space program. Ulbrich had to assure these companies that they would invest in the best laboratory equipment and implement quality control procedures on every order. The laboratory would cost more money than the company's profits in a year. Fred Sr. personally took out a loan to build the new testing laboratory. By 1969, Fred Sr.'s two other sons, Dick and Dan, made the Ulbrich Rolling Mill into a modern manufacturing company. Dick Ulbrich was vice president of production. He purchased new equipment and continually upgraded the systems to enable the mill to roll to even finer gauges. Ulbrich now stocked over 50 different alloys. There were 60 full-time employees working 3 shifts, and sales topped $10 million. In 1969, the company was incorporated as Ulbrich Stainless Steels and Special Metals.
A Ulbrich was furnishing metal to every major market: automotive, electrical, medical, defense, and energy. To be closer to its major customers, Ulbrich of Illinois was opened, an instant success. To expand their product line beyond strip, Ulbrich Wire was started to address the flat, square, round, and specialty-shaped wire markets. After the early 70s boom, the recession hit in 1975, and with it, the death of Fred Sr., founder of the company.
The brothers Fred Jr. and Dick Ulbrich restructured the company and set ambitious goals to achieve $100 million in sales by 1990. They designed an aggressive plan to make Ulbrich a national company by establishing additional service centers in Connecticut, Georgia, and California, building a new corporate headquarters and warehouse in North Haven, Connecticut, and additional space for Ulbrich of Illinois and Ulbrich Wire. By 1986, the entire expansion program was completed, with Ulbrich of California slitting its first coil. Sales approached $75 million.
In 1988, the first pistol shot of Ulbrich Revolution was heard, and management began implementing its four tenets. If Ulbrich was to become truly a world-class producer, all of its employees had to live and breathe the tenets. Training classes started, and sales reached $111 million.
In addition to increasing share in its core markets, the 90s brought Ulbrich growth by acquisition and greenfield development. Ulbrich was already stocking high-performance alloys in Paris, France for the European market, and actively trading into Japan when it established its first overseas facility, Ulbrich of United Kingdom in Sheffield, England, on the growing strength of the European Economic Community. The acquisition of Aerodyne Alloys, a national distributor, propelled Ulbrich into high-temperature bar, sheet, and plate products. It was followed by Metals and Cutting, a Los Angeles company specializing in small orders of aluminum, carbon, copper, and custom slitting of plastic.
Diversified Ulbrich of Canada, with service centers in Montreal and Toronto, was the next acquisition. Expanding on the leading edge of NAFTA, Ulbrich opened Ulbrinox, a new service center in Querétaro, Mexico, to service the growing Mexican and South American markets.
Today, the company has over 600 employees working in 18 different facilities in four countries, who are all highly trained and dedicated to producing the highest quality products.
We have a long history of craftsmanship. We have men and women who understand that you must do it right the first time. That good enough isn't good enough. It has to be perfect. And that's what we strive for. And that's what our entire company is built upon.
The Ulbrich legacy for quality has continued, and the company is managed by the third generation of Ulbrichs.
3 points in the UK. We're expanding our sales in the UK by about $2.5 million this year.
Chris Ulbrich, president, now directs a truly international company with sales approaching $250 million. Ulbrich's supply relationships have also grown, and it purchases material from all over the world to ensure that its customers' needs are met on time. Rolling, slitting, stocking, distributing, and cutting over 150 alloys for difficult-to-make products across a wide range of industries and applications to its customers' most demanding specifications. Ulbrich, a company founded by the vision of one man, transformed by its employees from scrap metal and cutlery to the precision metal products of today and tomorrow. Ulbrich Stainless Steels and Special Metals, three quarters of a century on the cutting edge.